Good afternoon, chaps. Today's lesson is all about improving your shooting by correct estimation of range and deflection. I hope you've all read the Airmentry's Bag the Hun manual, as I'm going to be asking questions. First, let's talk about range estimation. The span of a Focke-Wulf 190 or a Messerschmitt 109 is such that when it appears equal to the diameter of the Spitfire sight ring, when it is 100 yards away, half a diameter when it is 200 yards away, and so on. MacDonald, look at the Focke-Wulf at position A. How far away is it?
Looks about 100 yards to me, sir.
Too easy. Look at the rest. Boyd, what range is Focke-Wulf F at?
Is that 400 yards, sir?
Better. Now tell me which one you would shoot at and why.
That would be D, sir, at 200 yards. All my guns are set to converge at that range.
Smart arse.
Smart arse indeed, but correct. If your convergence is set to 200 yards, then all your guns will put a hell of a lot of lead into that hun at the same point. This film shows the combined destructive power Boyd's guns would have on the enemy aircraft if he shot at convergence range.
Aye, but only if he could bloody shit straight.
Now, look what happens at double the range. All the projectiles go wide. Let's talk about estimation of deflection. The amount of deflection depends chiefly on the angle off and on the speed of the hun. Let's hear from a couple of experts, which excludes most of you lot. Bob Stanford Tuck and Douglas Barder.
And explain it, will you?
Well, now, I'm the Messerschmitt here, coming down and I'm attacking the Spitfire. Now, the Spitfire has a remarkably good rate of turn, better than the Messerschmitt. Now, as they're turning steeply, the Messerschmitt, to shoot at the Spitfire, has got to really aim there, ahead of the Spitfire, because it's turning fast, what we call a deflection shot. But the Messerschmitt can't turn as quickly as the Spitfire, so therefore, all his shots are going astern here.
This film is taken from Boyd's cockpit. You can see his guns are aimed directly at the enemy, who just laugh as the bullets whiz harmlessly past behind. But here we see MacDonald taking the same shot, using the correct deflection to allow for the angle off.
Who's a clever boy then?
Brown, if you shot off your guns as much as you shot off your mouth, you might actually hit something.
Bloody dude, sir.
Now look at these. You may not believe it, but for each one, the range, the angle off, and the deflection is correct. MacDonald, tell me the range and angle off for these, and if the deflection is correct.
A is about 400 yards, 20 degrees, but there's not enough deflection. B is 200 yards, I think, at 5 degrees, but far, far too much deflection. C is 300 yards, 20 degrees, and I think that's a bullseye.
All correct. Excellent, MacDonald. So now let's look at some film of real examples. Thank you. Final test, chaps. Your turn, Brown. Show us what that mouth can do. In this diagram, where would you aim?
No problem with me, sir. A gets a hit at 0.4 and B gets a good kicking at 0.6.
So, you know it in theory. You'd better get it right in practice. The last two from you, Boyd.
C, I believe, should get it at position 3. And D at position 10.
That's more like it, man.
All you need now, Boyd's a whole lot more practice.
You'll get plenty of that where you're going. Here's the bell. Run like hell.